These days, battery electric vehicles dominate the discussion when it comes to EVs. But BMW has brought this prototype hydrogen fuel cell X5 SUV to Australia to remind us that BEVs are not the only potential solution for our zero emissions future. What do you reckon? Has hydrogen got a role to play? Let us know what you think in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos. To give this car its proper name, it's a BMW iX5 Hydrogen. To look at, it's pretty much a standard current fourth generation X5 large luxury SUV. All the interesting stuff is under the skin. This is one of almost 100 prototypes under test around the globe. You can't buy it and you probably couldn't afford it anyway. However, BMW does want to build a production version sometime down the track, and it says that could attain pricing equivalence with an electric X5. Okay, so this is a fuel cell electric vehicle, and what that means is hydrogen is stored on board and converted into electricity by a fuel cell stack, which sits here in this car under this pretty cover. There's also a battery, a lithium ion battery pack, just 5 kilowatts, but it's not there to store electricity. It's there to provide a power boost. All up, this car produces 295 kilowatts and can zip to 100 kilometers an hour in under 6 seconds. The iX5 stores 6 kilograms of hydrogen gas under high pressure at low temperature in 2 carbon-reinforced plastic tanks. One sits under the rear seat, the other where the transmission is housed in an orthodox X5. The claimed WLTP range of the iX5 Hydrogen is 504 kilometres, which translates to about 1.2 kilos of hydrogen consumed every 100 kilometres. One advantage fuel cell vehicles have over BEVs is their range isn't affected by weather extremes. Another is they take around the same time to refuel as a petrol car. Yep, only a few minutes. Like BEVs, fuel cell EVs emit no harmful emissions, but they still have a tailpipe, and that's for the water that's the result of the onboard chemical reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. Of course, the problem comes when it's time to refuel. Hydrogen's the most common element in the universe, but in Australia right now, there is only a handful of refueling stations, and even fewer with any form of public access. Okay, jump in the iX5 Hydrogen, and wow, it looks very production in here. You'd be hard pressed to pick it from a standard X5 SUV. There's a few indicators, of course, hydrogen fuel cell written across the dashboard and on the door sills. There's some blue trim touches, and the fuel consumption in the trip computer is in kilograms of hydrogen per 100 kilometers instead of liters of fuel per 100 kilometers. Okay, so the battery pack and the e-motor are integrated under the floor on the rear axle, showing how well this job's been done. Boot space is completely unaffected. Full amount of luggage can be fitted in here. All right, enough of all that sort of stuff. Let's close her up and go for a drive. And oh yeah, on this side. I'm not going to pretend we've had the most extensive drive of the BMW iX5 Hydrogen. It's been a couple of laps of the ride and handling circuit, the Lang Lang Proving Ground that used to be owned by Holden. But it's been enough to establish, like the interior presentation, like the exterior presentation, that this is very much a vehicle that feels production ready. It's not that fuel cell technology introduces some new, different feeling driving experience to electric vehicles. It's the same as a battery electric vehicle. It's just that the electricity is stored and delivered in a different way. So you get that very quick tip in throttle acceleration typical of electric vehicles, and you get a very quiet and seemly progress as well. If you want to make it a bit noisier, you've always got the Hans Zimmer soundtrack at your disposal. In the way it rides and steers and handles, this is familiar BMW X5 stuff. There's nothing revolutionary or really different here. Very solid, capable and comfortable car. It is rear wheel drive though. which is something different to every other X5 currently sold in Australia. In the end, what impresses most about the BMW iX5 Hydrogen is its completeness. There's no doubt this is very much a production feeling, drive and presentation of technology. All BMW is really doing here is reinforcing what hydrogen fans, Hyundai and Toyota have previously done, letting us know that this technology is ready to power mass production vehicles. Sadly, the infrastructure needed to refuel them is far from ready. So that until that is fixed, drives of prototypes like this are really all these vehicles are good for.